Hi there. I'll be working on a Porsche Cayman S today, and I remember a friend of mine asking me how to go around machine polishing rounded and curvy panels. So I thought it would be a great time to share this tip with you. So stay tuned and find out. Generally, there are two types of curves. One is called a concave and the other is called a convex. Now, so let me begin with the convex first. Firstly, this, like this, is a little bit like flexed out. Okay, flex, convex. So this is a convex panel. How most people would polish is like this, all right? And they work one section. So most people would think that, oh, I'm actually hitting so much, all right? Pad size and I'm hitting so much, but if you actually look it from the side, you are only working this much over here. Okay, top here and here, you don't actually hit it. So what happens here is you want to split this one pass, one section, into three sections instead. One section here, second section, and the third section. Okay, one, two, and three. So in other words, the first tip I want you to remember is to keep the overlapping passes tight, all right? So I'll start from here, I'll do this, and then I'll come down a little bit, and I do this, and I come down one more time to do this. So three overlapping passes in what a normal one section pass would do for convex panels. Okay, that's number one, keep the overlapping passes tight. Number two, so I'll call this technique the hugging technique. So this is a, let's just say this is a curve, a convex panel, and then you want to go like this. You want to go like this. You see, it's like as if you are hugging the panel, hugging the convex. So put it in perspective. Start from here, you hug. All right, you go like this. Right, you go like this. Okay, so when you fuse the two techniques together, having tight overlapping passes, and then you hug it, okay, tight, and hug. Alright, you will get the most out of the convex, and then you are able to hit contacts. And as always in polishing, contact is very important, and if you do not hit it, you cannot polish it. Okay, so the second curve that we're going to talk about today is a concave curve. Okay, so this part over here is what we call a concave. See how it's sunken into a cave, like a cave, concave. So when it comes to this, there's only one thing you need to pay attention is never follow through, all right? Never do it this way, okay? Never follow through, all right? If you do it this way, you might burn here, and you might burn here, and you will not polish here, okay? This is a big no-no, okay? In fact, what you should do is you should come in from both sides. Come in from here, and coming from here. All right, here and here. So for concave, you want to come in from both sides, and then use what I call a scooping technique. So because of this angle, all right, if you push it down just at the 12 o'clock dot, you might not get the side, okay? For this, I would push at the 12 to, I'll push at the 1 o'clock dot, which is somewhere here, right? And then I sort of like scooping up something, right? Scooping up to get most contact on this concave. 1 o'clock dot. One or maybe two, I don't know, depends on how you see it. And then this is the first angle. And then from the top part, all right? So if I'm seeing from here, 12 o'clock, 1 o'clock. So press at 1 o'clock and come in. All right, this way you will get the most of the concave areas. Okay, I'll run it on the machine to give you a better illustration, and I'll also do a animation or 2D to better illustrate things. So hopefully you get it. Okay, that's all I got for you today. I hope you find this video helpful, and if you do find this video helpful, please share it with your friends. And if you like videos like this in the future, remember to subscribe to our channel for more videos like this coming your way. I'll see you next time. Thanks for watching until the end. Actually, there's two more things I forgot to share. I think I'll share it to you now. So, I mentioned about concave and convex, right? So right now I want to share with you like 90, the almost 90 degree convex and 90 degree concave. So when it's almost 90 degrees, you can see this sharp little thing here. You want to avoid this thing at all costs, all right? So you work here, you can pressure it, no worries. But when you work here, never pressure on this sharp edge, on this 90 degree convex, all right? You can work the top, you can use the scooping technique, but never pressure on this thing here, okay? So the top, don't press, come down and work here. Okay, so skip the middle. Now, another thing is, what if it's 90% concave or almost 90% concave? So I have a setup here, like this part here. It's almost 90%, I don't know, almost 90 degrees, maybe it's like what, 70, 80? So don't even touch it. For me, I wouldn't polish it at all, or maybe I'll just put some polish onto your microfiber and I just scrub it here, all right? So, you know, as much detailing or as much details as we want to be, sometimes I think this is not so beneficial. You do not get extra marks just because we get rid of some scratch or defect there. In fact, if you burn the paint, probably you'll be penalized more for burning the paint and rather than the effort that you try to get those defects out. So machine cannot go there, there's no source there, don't go there. Alright, probably some oxidation or stains or anything, just knock it out by hand. So yeah, that's all I got for you today, and I'm really gotta go now. See you next time.